Ladies and gentlemen, we are about to commence and begin the commencement ceremony. Again, please take your seats and remain seated during the recessional. And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the distinguished faculty of the Pepperdine University Graziadio Business School. And now, ladies and gentlemen, please give a warm and enthusiastic welcome to your friends and family who today are the Executive Program's graduating classes of 2020 and 2021 from the Pepperdine Graziadio School, led by the inaugural cohort of the Doctor of Business Administration Program and its first graduates. Thank you. And finally, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the platform party.
All right, one, two.
Ladies and gentlemen, the commencement ceremony for executive programs at the Pepperdine Graziadio Business School is hereby opened. The invocation for today's ceremony will be offered by Dr. Gary Mangiofico, Executive Professor of Management and Leadership and Academic Director for the Master of Science in Organizational Development Program. Next, we will recite the Pledge of Allegiance, led by Brian McGilvery, Practitioner, Faculty of Business Law at the Graziadio School. And finally, the National Anthem will be performed by Soren Hazarian, member of the Graziadio Business School Class of 2020. Could I ask you please to all stand for the invocation and Pledge of Allegiance and remain standing for the singing of our National Anthem.
Thank you, Dr. Mooney. Everyone, before we bow our heads in prayer, I'd like to turn your attention briefly to the empty chair sitting here on the stage. This chair has been placed here in honor of the faculty members of the Graziadio School that we have lost over the past year. Out of respect for these distinguished mentors, Owen Hall, Alan Heusman, Stuart Fleisch, Thomas Dudley, and Wayne Strom, along with their family and friends that they left behind, we now offer a moment of silence. Thank you. Let us now pray together. God of peace, we invite you to preside over this graduation ceremony, that it may inspire everyone here, especially our graduates, as they rise up and celebrate today. Lord, we pray that you will guide them not only as they mark this time of transition, but as they rise up to venture forward on life's journey. No matter their origins or which walk of life they come from, give them unity of spirit today to fulfill your calling and help them to rise up and be enlightened, caring, and compassionate. Direct them to know deep truths so that they have the moral knowledge to rise up with the needed wisdom to change the world. Lord, we ask your blessings upon our graduates. Bless them to rise up and see the needs of others and be one another's keeper. Bless them with your light and wisdom in their hearts and minds, so that as they rise up, they take the right path to make a mark in this life. Bless them with the clarity and commitment to fulfill their promise, and use their privilege to rise up to encourage the hearts and minds of others to fulfill theirs. Bless them with grace, humility, and open hearts to hear all voices and ideas, and to rise up to create a place where every person matters. With your blessings, O Lord, may each one here know that they are the possibility of something unique, and to rise up to make manifest their gift to the world. And we ask your blessings for the family and friends here today, the faculty who have collaborated and shared their knowledge with these graduates, our president, dean, provost, and the members here on this platform for their words of guidance and support. We ask that you shine your countenance upon this graduation and upon these graduates today as they rise up. We ask this in the strong and loving name of Jesus. Amen.
Please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched with so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Awesome. That was awesome.
Thank you, colleagues. You may now be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my great pleasure to introduce the Provost of Pepperdine University, Dr. Jay Brewster.
Well, good afternoon, everyone. It is good to be here. Amen. Welcome. On behalf of the entirety of Pepperdine University, I'm delighted to welcome all of you here to the commencement ceremony for the executive programs at the Graziadio Business School. Success in academics, success in business requires hard work. We celebrate that journey today in addition to its conclusion, knowing that the skills, resolve, and mental fortitude of these talented students have built over their years of studies, that these skills will serve them well as they begin their careers in the business world. We also celebrate and look forward with anticipation to the opportunities they will acquire in those careers. Opportunities not only to grow their enterprises and to build wealth, but to share that wealth with the communities that nurtured them on their roads to achievement. They could hardly ask for a better example to follow than the founder of this university, George Pepperdine. Mr. Pepperdine's own business career started with a mere $5 in his pocket, but through wisdom, determination, entrepreneurship, and yes, good old-fashioned hard work, he turned that initial investment into a fast-growing retail company that served every part of the United States. He wasn't content to just amass major wealth and content himself with living a life of luxury. He wanted to help accelerate future generations on their own paths to success, and his namesake college was the vehicle he chose for doing so. As a permanent reminder of that motivation and to inspire similar generosity in those who followed him, Mr. Pepperdine, a deeply religious man, chose Matthew chapter 10, verse 8 as the motto for this university. Freely ye received, freely give. Today we also honor and celebrate the example set by the benefactor for whom Pepperdine Business School is named. today, not tomorrow, this simple yet powerful statement is one of George L. Graziadio's defining testaments to purpose-driven leadership. A grandson of Italian immigrants, George Graziadio came to America in pursuit of opportunity. Learning directly from his father, he soon grew to be successful and set his sights on California, where he'd meet the love of his life, Riva, and start a family. With his business partner, he opened the first Imperial Bank, which helped turn Los Angeles into the economic powerhouse that it is known for today. In 1996, George and Riva Graziadio endowed the business school that holds the name we see today. His unwavering support for Pepperdine's values of service, purpose, and leadership paved the way for our mission of helping, of developing best for the world leaders, leaders who advance responsible business to make a positive impact on both the organization and its surrounding communities. Today we thank George Graziadio for his legacy, his guidance, and entrepreneurial spirit, and honor him through our commitment to purpose-driven leadership. The Graziadio School is proud to honor a tradition at commencement, giving an especially distinguished member of the graduating class an opportunity to offer their own personal reflections as they prepare to embark on the next chapter of their life and career. I am pleased today to introduce today's student speaker, Sharifa Batts. Let's clap for her. Welcome, Sharifa, who today will receive a doctorate degree in business, administration, management, and operations. Sharifa earned her bachelor's degree in political science and psychology from San Diego State University in 1996 and an MBA from the Graziadio School in 2018. For the past 21 years, she has worked at Ports America, the largest terminal operator in the United States, where she currently serves as Director of Safety. In this role, she oversees the company's safety programs and provides strategic guidance and professional expertise. Her leadership has contributed to year-over-year safety improvement throughout the company and numerous safety awards. In addition to being an accomplished executive, Sharifa is a published author in trade journals and participates in speaking events that focus on diversity, inequality, systemic racism, and organizational leadership. Her doctoral dissertation at Graziadio focused on the significance of diversity on organizational boards and the unique contributions that minorities and women make to the overall success of their companies. Through her efforts to reduce workplace inequality and change stereotypes and misconceptions about minorities and women in business, Sharifa says she hopes to be a role model for women and other underrepresented groups in the corporate world. Pepperdine strives to be a place of belonging for all, regardless of race or background, and we are proud to see one of our graduates doing the same for the world of business. Please join me in welcoming and congratulating Sharifa Batts.
Thank you to our Heavenly Father and Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, to our Dean, Deryck van Rensburg, Dr. John Mooney, my wonderful committee, Dr. Christina Gibson, Dr. Bobby Thomason, and Dr. Felton Williams, the Pepperdine faculty and staff, my fellow inaugural DBA cohort, the PKE, EMBA, and MSOD graduates, and all of our family and friends for your love, support, and patience throughout our academic journeys. A special thank you to my mom, Hattie, my husband, Cameron, daughters, Sydney and Camilla, son-in-laws, Shai and LaFelton, and all of my grandchildren. Members of the executive programs, we did it! We are a diverse group with a broad range of ethnicities, gender, background, ages, and personality types. We are best for the world leaders. In August 2018, I graduated with my Executive MBA 115 South cohort, and I wanted to be successful. So I immediately started the rigorous DBA program, which was challenging and mirrored one of my elite 400-meter hurdle races, as it pushed all of us to our limits as we balanced school, family, and work during a pandemic. We all experienced many slips and falls along the way, but we continued to get up through the adversity. We kept our eyes focused on the finish line, and we are here, graduation day. Throughout my EMBA and DBA journey, people constantly asked, so what are you gonna do when you graduate? And each time I would respond with, oh, I'm saving that for Dr. Batts. And then each year that went by, I became more nervous because eventually I was gonna have to respond. Then 2020 came, and the world as we knew it changed dramatically. COVID hit, and no one could have anticipated the worldly impact. Masses of people were and still are dying. Students could not physically attend class or graduation, and the 405 in Las Vegas were empty for the first time. Then the Black Lives Matter movement happened, and people from all across the world were focused on Americans in protest, and many questioned, does systemic racism really exist? Then we had our election, and people questioned, was it rigged, voter suppression? Then the attack on our Capitol, income inequality, and climate change, and as my Auntie Barbara would say, what in the world was happening to our country? All of these events occurred during our graduate journey, and they were eye-openers. Then I read a quote from Albert Einstein that shifted my mindset. He said, try not to become a man of success, but rather become a man of value. I sat back and I thought, in this day and age, we are needed. We are people of value. It doesn't matter if you're Black, Hispanic, Asian, Jewish, Indian, or any other ethnicity, including Caucasian. We are all human, where diversity, equity, inclusion, and belonging starts with each one of us making a difference. Being a best for the world leader, it's a lifestyle with many ups and downs, and we started or continued that lifestyle with the degree that each of us are graduating with today. We all have to have the courage to be bold, the courage to be different and be around others who are different, and the courage to listen to those who are diverse. You know, to turn something around requires positive change, which could be uncomfortable because many of us have to step out of our comfort zone to meet people or do things that may feel awkward. But when you lead by example and you do the right thing, even when confronted with adversity or becoming impervious, you will make a difference. I will tell a quick story and then wrap this up. A man was walking along the beach, and he could see a young boy bending down, picking something up and throwing something into the water. The man approached, and he saw the boy was picking up and throwing starfish that washed up on the beach, and he was throwing them back in the ocean, or they would die. The man tells the boy, "You can't possibly save them all, as there's hundreds of beaches along the coast, so you can't possibly make a difference." The boy smiled, he bent down, he picked up one more starfish, and as he threw it back into the ocean, he said, "I made a difference for that one." You see, the world has so many problems that are bigger than ourselves, and it is easy to feel overwhelmed and to feel as if our tiny little brick may not make a difference at all. But everything we do has a ripple effect on the people we cross paths with, and we add value. Barbara Mikulski said it best, each one of us can make a difference, but together we make change. The bricks we added to the wall will make a difference. We are best for the world leaders. And I challenge not only the members of my cohort, but everyone here today to collaborate with someone who does not look like you, maybe a different ethnicity or gender, to help make a difference through inclusion. Because when someone feels a sense of belonging, they want to have a stronger impact. Thank you, and may God bless us all.
Thank you, Sharifa. It is so great to have you with us today. Congratulations on this achievement. We're so glad to have the guests that you've brought with you today, and I'd like to introduce some of them, or all of them, hopefully. Your husband, Cameron, and I would ask you to rise and stay standing as we ask the guests to stand up. Welcome, Cameron. Your daughters, Camilla Batts, Sydney Traxler, and son-in-law, Shahid Clemens. Your grandchildren, Phoenix and London Traxler and Damian Batts. Your mother, Hattie Ree Herring. Welcome. Your brother and sister-in-law, Raymond Herring and Asia Cox. Welcome. Nephew, Kai Cox. There he is. Cousins, Aisha Stokes and Aisha Logan. There they are, welcome. And your external reviewer from your dissertation committee, great work, Dr. Felton Williams, welcome. So, any other guests, if I've missed anyone, please rise up so that we can, thank you very much. A welcome to you all and congratulations. Next, we'd like to honor our distinguished alumnus. We're privileged indeed today to welcome today's graduates, all of them, into the Pepperdine alumni community, which now numbers more than 100,000 leaders and entrepreneurs around the world. It is a tradition for us to recognize a member of that alumni community who has likewise represented the Graziadio Business School with distinction through their dedication, business success, and exemplary character. To present the Distinguished Alumnus Award for 2021, I would now like to invite to the podium Dean Deryck van Rensburg and President Jim Gash to welcome our alumnus.
President Gash, it has been said many times that we are currently in a golden age of television, an age in which the options are greater, the stories are deeper, the production is richer, and the images are more unforgettable than ever before. I'm proud that one of our own Graziadio graduates has played such an important role in building this era of groundbreaking entertainment. For 9 years, Andy Kubitz served as Executive Vice President for Programming Strategy at ABC Entertainment, where he oversaw daytime, primetime, and late-night programming and coordinated strategies across all of ABC's platforms, including video on demand. When the Walt Disney Company, ABC's parent, acquired 21st Century Fox 2 years ago, Andy played a key role in the integration of the two organizations' programming, devising cross-platform strategy for a vast array of both TV networks and streaming services. He also helped bring some of the country's most eagerly anticipated event programming from the NBA Finals to the Academy Awards to millions of viewers. But just as important as where he has ended up is where he started. A videographer for the ABC affiliate in Wisconsin, his first job in network television was as a page at CBS Television City here in Los Angeles. But through determination, vision, and a dedicated work ethic, Andy worked his way up through the ranks to become Senior Vice President of Program Planning and Scheduling. Andy, I'm sure there are many more entertainment moguls potentially in our midst right here today, and they would love to hear from you. But regardless, your career presents a superb example of what hard work and doing things the right way can accomplish, even in the incredibly competitive entertainment industry. And for that reason, I am proud and delighted to present Andy Kubitz, member of the Graziadio Business School's Presidents and Key Executive Class of 2011, with our 2021 Distinguished Alumnus Award.
Well, that's a lot to live up to. And the earlier speech was fantastic. So, you know, I'll keep this brief. It's only going to be about an hour, so it'll be good. But thank you, Dean Van Rensburg, and President Gash, and all of Pepperdine University. You know, it's an honor and a privilege to be recognized in this way, so thank you so much. But I don't stand up here alone. I stand up here with my wife, Christy. I said I won't get emotional, but I'm not. She was the one who watched our two kids while I went back to school. And she took on the role of the single parent when I got to take on this role as a distinguished alumni. So thank you, Christy. But congratulations to all of you for making it here today, and for all those people who stand behind you so that you could reach this pinnacle in your life right now. Since I was asked to be here, I've been reflecting on how I got here. You know, the truth be told, I'm just a kid from a very small town in Wisconsin who came to California to follow his dream to work in television. My town was so small, I think the entire population could fit underneath this tent, actually. And what has the television business taught me? Well, a big lesson in television is that there's a lot of failure. It's an R&D business. And the misses outweigh the hits. TV in general has about a 30% success rate for new shows. 3 out of every 10 shows make it from its first season to its second season. That means, in my 25 years, I've watched a lot of bad television. But getting through the fear of failing 70% of the time means I got to get to some of the greatest television, zeitgeist, culturally changing TV programs. So now I look back at myself and I think, I overcame my fears of failure. And that has helped me in my work, in my life, and for me to be a more well-rounded person. Now, I'm not talking about the motivational fear, the one that drives people and like yourselves to be great. I'm talking about the little fears that hold you back from being great. And it goes back to my move from to California. If I wanted my dreams to come true, I needed to fight the doubt and overcome my small town fears. And it was hard to convince me, my family, and all those people around me that it was okay to leave a village of 4,000 to a city of 4 million, and then start an entirely new life. And it's hard to convince me and those around me, we all carry some doubt in our lives. And I think, you know, it's become a big part of our highly complex business world today. Fear can change every aspect of your life. And to tell you the truth, I'm terrified to be up here. I'm actually afraid of public speaking. But I don't let that fear control my life. And fear is hardwired into the human body. It triggers that fight or flight response, and it's in the deepest part of our psyche. I'm not a big fan of letting anything control me. So I mustered up a pound of courage today, and I did the opposite. I'm standing here. So I'm a visual learner, so work with me here. It's my unscientific belief that it takes an ounce of fear. If they were two physical objects, fear and courage, it takes about an ounce of fear and a pound of courage to outweigh each other. Now, it's really a lot of hard work, and you have to expand a lot of energy to overcome fear. It's hardwired into our brains, so we must make more courage. And you have to make a pound of courage every day. Confidence, love, compassion, hard work, and wisdom are some of the ingredients, but there are many more. And your recipe will be as different as you are unique. Now, I'm not saying to ignore all fear. Now, if a pack of wild dogs comes down the street, drop the pound, run like hell, right? But every day, we have moments we need courage. We need it when we express our uniqueness, or fighting for those less fortunate than ourselves, and when we stand up for ourselves and our ideals. Today's graduation and all the work it represents will be part of your recipe, but you are not alone. Others in your life will give you ingredients. or in some cases, they'll give you your entire pound. But it's important for you to find your very own secret recipe. Pepperdine and Graziadio School of Business was a huge recipe for me, so much so that after I graduated, I was ready to take on every one of my fears, especially my biggest, my fear of heights. So I threw into a bowl some confidence and some wisdom and some love from friends and family, and a few weeks after graduation, I jumped out of a plane at 18,000 feet. Okay, it might have taken a little bit more than 1 pound, but I did it, and that's the important part. Now, that's my story, and you get to now make your own stories. Because remember, fear has changed our workplace and our societies. Fear has become a strong component around many boardroom tables and dining room tables. In today's world, fear has been weaponized and it comes at you from every direction. And it's very powerful in its small doses. So have your pound ready when you ask for that promotion. Those whispered to you, you probably won't get that. Have it ready when you pitch that idea that some thought was crazy, but you believe you're gonna change the world. Have that pound ready when people tell you to fear anyone who doesn't look like you, speak like you, or love like you do. It will be the small acts of courage that make your life that much richer. It will take all of our courage together that will make our entire world a little bit better. It is now your time to be courageous. Thank you very much, Pepperdine. I appreciate it, and good luck, and congratulations to you all on this amazing day. Thank you.
Thank you, Andy.
Thank you. What a privilege it is to hear from someone who held so much responsibility in an industry that is so vital to the city and the region that we call home. Thank you, Andy, for joining us today, and thank you for bringing some guests with you. Could I ask the guests to rise as I name you off? Christy Kubitz, could you please rise? Thank you and welcome. Your sons, Aiden and Cole. I asked Cole if he thought he could stay awake through the whole speech, and I think he made it, right? You made it. Good job. And your PKE classmate, Danielle Beasley. Very good. Thank you for being here. We'll now begin our degree ceremony. Joining President Gash to present the candidates for the doctoral degrees is Dean Deryck van Rensburg.
Will the candidates for doctoral degrees please rise? President Gash, this is our inaugural cohort, the first students at the business school to receive a doctoral degree. Congratulations. They have successfully completed their prescribed courses and their dissertation research and are recommended by the amazing faculty of the Graziadio Business School to receive their doctorate degrees.
Thank you for that pound of courage it took to be the inaugural class. And thank you, Dean Van Rensburg. Upon your recommendation and that of the faculty of the Graziadio Business School, and by the authority vested in me by the Board of Regents of the Pepperdine University, I confer upon you your doctorate degree with all the rights, duties, and privileges thereto appertaining. Congratulations.
You can move forward. Thank you.
Doctor of Business Administration, Sharifa Batz. Anna Brandt. Brian Charles Mulligan. Stephen Blair Franklin. Frank Betts. Oh, okay. Gil Kynan. Grayland Weary. George Daglian. Jolie Gutentag.
So will the candidates for master's degrees please rise? President Gash, these individuals have successfully completed their prescribed courses and are recommended by the faculty of the Graziadio Business School to receive their master's degrees.
Thank you, Dean Van Rensburg. Upon your recommendation and that of the faculty of the Graziadio Business School, and by the authority vested in me by the Board of Regents of Pepperdine University, I am pleased to confer upon each of you the master's degree with all the rights, privileges, and duties thereto appertaining. Congratulations.
Okay, the first row of graduates may come forward. All the others may remain seated until it is time for your row to proceed to the platform. And then, graduates, after receiving your diploma, you may return to your seats.
Master of Science in Organization Development, Darby Barton. Tiffany Burrows. Angie Bogatti. Charlotte Booth. Aaron Brick. Matthew Ebeling. Marnie Makowski. Melanie Morris. Lindsay Sands. Annie Severson. Elizabeth Taylor. Natalie Weathers. Master of Business Administration Executive, Bobby Akbaroff. Jennifer Allen. John Blubaugh. Benjamin Brody. Christine Bowie. Chad Cardinal. Stephen Carroll. Nicholas Kokas. Ashley Copley. Jacqueline Engel. Vanessa Fagioli. David Endine. Shane Jolinas. Surin Hazarian. Alan Hernandez. Nilish Hingar. Amanda Hoffman. Kevin Hurley. Kathy Ingersoll. Whitney Coford. John Lindquist. Robert Malecki. Veronica Messer. Dario Miucci. Suzanne Moore. Irina Mohassin. Vince Wynn. Christine Ney. Jose Ocampo. Nikunj Patel. Philip Payne. Michael Pugies. Christina Petrie. Carrie Romgren. Carlos Rivera. Krishan Singh. Lexi St. John. Lucy Rivera. Vincent Sullivan. Jackie Takei. Melanie Tisman. Tulima Tuanaki. Reese Tyler. Blake Wolfis. Cayetano Urias. Corey Valencia. Rebecca Wagner. Kenny Walls. Cole Witcher. Master of Business Administration Presidential, Brian Barrera. George Rodriguez.
Congratulations, classes of 2020 and 2021. You've waited a long time to be back on campus, and we're thrilled that you're back with us. As Provost Brewster alluded to earlier, one of the purposes of the commencement ceremony is to celebrate all of the hard work that you've put in and all that you've learned over the course of your studies. I feel that's especially meaningful for all of you who have received your degrees today, as you have had to balance those demanding studies with the great responsibilities of a career in executive management. Many of you also had families to tend to, volunteer obligations to fulfill, and other demands on your time. I hope you know how much we at Pepperdine respect and admire you for successfully managing all of these important considerations and still arriving at this spot in your careers today. Let's take a moment right now for you to show the gratitude and affection to the parents, spouses, friends, children, and all the other loved ones who have been at your side during your academic journey and who will continue to walk with you wherever your career journeys take you. Of course, your professors and mentors at Graziadio have also played an important role in this journey. So why don't we take a moment to show appreciation to them for all that they've done to get you here today. Just because you're ending your course of study here at Pepperdine doesn't mean that your education is ending. It is our fondest hope that you make learning a lifelong passion. We hope that even as you sat here today, you learned a few important lessons from the example set by George Pepperdine and George Graziadio and our distinguished alum, Andy Kubitz. That there is a place in the business world for people who want to do things the right way, who want to include others in their successes, and who recognize that even at the highest levels of corporate leadership, there are motivations higher than making a profit. These great individuals enriched entire communities through their business success, not just themselves. I hope that each of you will be inspired to do the same. The business world, as you know well, is a competitive one, and one in which you will encounter many temptations over the course of your careers. You will encounter people who are inclined to cut ethical corners and to treat other people as mere stepping stones in their path to success. When that happens, I hope you'll remember Mr. Pepperdine and Mr. Graziadio and be reminded that you do not have to give in to those temptations to be successful. Acting with integrity will never interfere with your long-term corporate success. Neither will treating others with the same respect that you would want to be treated with, whether those people are corporate CEOs, workers with whom you contract, or the people who clean your office space. Everyone, even those we describe as self-made, has had partners, assistants, supporters, and friends to help them pave the road to achievement. Taking the time to remember, respect, and show gratitude to those people will always be time well spent. And now, as Marshal John Mooney prepares to conclude our ceremony, I would like to welcome the Distinguished Chancellor of Pepperdine University, Sarah Young Jackson, to offer our benediction. Will everyone please rise for the benediction and remain seated after the benediction for the recessional.
Thank you, President Gash.
What a wonderful ceremony this has been. Thank you all for your part in it, and thank you for Sharifa and Andy for your inspiring messages. Will you join me in prayer? As we begin to bow our heads before the Lord, let's remember the scripture, Proverbs 16:3. Commit to the Lord whatever you do, and he will establish your plans. May that be true for your life. Heavenly Father, we begin by thanking you simply for the fact that we all get to be here today together, enjoying each other's fellowship as we celebrate the achievements of these graduates in this beautiful setting. Let us never forget how important these connections are, nor the roles we play as friends, partners, counselors, and companions in the lives of others. Lord, even as we celebrate all these graduates and all that they've accomplished, we know they will shoulder great responsibilities, and they do shoulder great responsibilities over the course of their careers. We pray that their decisions will be guided by your wisdom as they have integrity and moral character in all that they do. Help them to be not just leaders, but servant leaders, people who put the good of others before themselves, who respect others no matter their station in life, and who inspire others to dream. And finally, Lord, we ask for your blessing upon these graduates, their families, their friends, who have unselfishly cheered them on, and bless this entire Pepperdine community. Fill us with your spirit that we might continue to serve you with full and reverent hearts and a boundless desire to leave our communities and our world better than we found them. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you, Chancellor Jackson. If I could ask the graduates and the faculty and platform party to please remain standing. Guests, could I ask you please to take your seats for the recessional and remain seated until the recessional has completed. This commencement ceremony for the executive programs of the Pepperdine University Graziadio Business School is now concluded. Thank you so much to our guests for being here to celebrate your accomplishments with your friends and family. We wish you all a fabulous evening and rest of weekend and a safe journey home. God bless.